Our government is ramping up its efforts to promote a startup ecosystem in the state. And as a part of these plans, the government's nodal body, the Kerala Startup Mission, has set itself a target of making 1,500 crore rupees available for funding for various ventures. CNBC TV18's Jude Sannith reports on how the mission plans to raise these funds and what kind of ventures are in the running for this money.
Since 2015, Kerala's startup ecosystem has seen 300 crore rupees flow in from angel investors and venture capitalists, and the government's Kerala Startup Mission, or KSUM, is keen on pushing this number up fivefold in the next 4 years.
In the next 4 years, we wanted to create a value of around 10,000 crores in the startup ecosystem. When I say 10,000 crores, I don't expect the 10,000 crores to come, but the value of the startups in Kerala should be close to that amount. So if you are looking at around 15% coming as funding, I'm basically targeting something around 1,500 crores.
The ramp up in funding will of course be gradual. CNBC TV18 learns that KSUM has set a 20 crore rupee funding target for December and has identified 50 of the 757 startups registered with it as possible candidates for Series A funding. Now, the state's startup policy allows the government to contribute 50% of a startup's initial funding needs, and since it has already disbursed 15 crore rupees, the government is being picky about where it invests.
Money which government is putting on this is fairly limited. It can't grow every year. So we are trying to reduce the government exposure and get more funds to invest in this thing.
So KSUM is talking to Unicorn Ventures and C Fund to secure investment in 7 early stage startups. Other names like Sequoia, Axel and Conglo Ventures have also expressed their interest in some of these startups. In the 2 years since its inception, the Kerala Startup Mission has helped startups in the state secure close to 230 crore worth of venture capital from a variety of funds. But the Kerala government's nodal body now has its sights set on a new source of funding, and that's the Middle East.
We are basically creating investor awareness camps in Middle East, and maybe the first one we are going to do it in January, where we are trying to target high net worth individuals and start looking at how do they actually invest on the startups here.
Clearly the intentions are good, but whether this will result in Kerala giving other startup hubs in India a run for their money will largely depend on just how well Kerala builds its ecosystem and lifts itself from the 20th position in the state-wise ease of doing business rankings. In Kochi, Jude Sannith.